Have you ever made a leaf lately? I'm sure that all of you guys have experience in making a list. So then, what kind of list do you usually make? Is it to-do list or grocery list? When I was an elementary school student, I made a list for the first time. I wrote down what I wanted to buy at the time. My list was completed with colorful candies, popular stickers, lovely teddy bears, and so on. Sometimes I could get these things, but the other times my mom wouldn't allow me to have these things that I didn't really need. So when my desire for certain things started getting out of control, I wrote down what I needed most. That was the first list I've ever created. After I wrote the list, I was surprised at the number of the thing that I wanted, but also I was satisfied, even though I hadn't yet received anything that I wanted. Of course, I really wanted the thing itself, but at the same time, just imagining that I have these things fulfills my heart desire. So I realized making a list made me happy. Since then, I make a list for whatever I want to list off. However, the thing that I put in my list and the reason why I make a list has changed. Now I make a list to be happier. Can you guys say you feel happy every night before going to bed? It seems to be easy, but as we're getting older, it becomes harder and harder. Of course, there are a lot of things that make us depressed, sad, unhappy, and unhappy. Unhappiness affects all of us from time to time. In addition, we are wired to adapt our situation really quickly, which means if we are happy in certain situation, this happiness won't so long time. Because after we adapt to situation, it has become just normal for us. This scary phenomenon is called hedonic adaptation. According to Richard E. Lucas and Andrew E. Clarkson's study about this phenomenon, it is said after a couple got married, their peak happiness could last only 2 years. After they got used to their happiest time, they don't feel happiness as much as before because it has just become normal for them. It is sad, isn't it? Yeah. All the more, I think we should focus on happiness to enhance our daily satisfaction of life and to avoid this scary phenomenon, hedonic adaptation. Based on studies, it is said people who are happy can live 10 years longer than people who are not happy. So, how can we live happier? To focus on happiness, I started making a happy list every day. My happy list is just so simple. I just write down what I was glad to at the day, almost like a journaling. The point in my happy list could be anything. It could be small thing or it could be big thing. This could be just 3 things or more than 10 things. It could be anything, as long as it really brought me happiness. Before I go to bed, I ask myself, what made you happy today? To see Fluffy Dog in a streetcar, to go to a cafe that I wanted to go, to remember a new recipe, to enjoy Netflix at home, or to feel fresh air in the morning. This happiness from my real happy list. This could be small happiness, but think of big happiness that can stay in your mind long time. This don't happen every day, right? So our lives are made from a lot of small happiness and some of big happiness, like this. Here is a quote from Andy Rooney. For most of life, nothing wonderful happens. If you don't enjoy getting up and working and finishing your work and sitting down to a meal with your friend or family, then the chances are you're not going to be very happy. If, on the other hand, happiness depends on a good breakfast, a flower in the earth, a drink or a nap, then we are more likely to live with quite a bit of happiness. Henry David Thoreau said, "The man is richest whose pleasures are cheapest." So, in this activity, most important thing is focus on small happiness that make our day. Making a happy list is same as visualization of happiness. This is the biggest point and biggest reason to make a happy list. After I visualize my joy, literally I can see and I can read my joy. When I make it into words, I can organize my thoughts as well. Then I realized my life is full of happiness. Moreover, once I wrote down my thoughts, my happy list, I can keep it almost forever. So when I feel low, I see my happy list. I read my happy list. My happy list reminds me my bliss, and it encourages me. This happy list could be a kind of medicine for me when I feel depressed. My happy list brought me new perspective in my life. When I was a high school student, I was depressed about who I was. I don't like myself, I didn't like myself, and I always compared myself to others every time. In my class, there were a lot of students who are good at study or good at sports or even both. So when I looked at myself, it seems that the other students were always better than me. In my mind, I was the worst. I tried harder and harder. I disappointed myself because I tried a lot, but I couldn't get top score on the test. And I'm good bad at all kinds of sports since I was a kid. So I was afraid of failure too much, so I didn't take any chances at all. So I was in a kind of bad cycle then. And I felt like I have nothing. I am nothing. However, after I make a happy list, I changed gradually. I was pessimist before, and I was worried about others' opinion too much. But now I know if I made a mistake, it will be fine, and everything is going to be okay. And it brought me new perspective. Others are others, I am I. So I don't need to compare myself to others. So I started to take on chances as much as possible to get my new perspective and new experience for me. To study abroad in Canada and to speak here at TEDx are also big, big challenges for me. Previous me wouldn't do that. Making a happy list leads me the bright side of my life. And 4 years have passed since I started to making a happy list. Now I can find any tiny piece of happiness in my life, and I got used to reframing from negative thought to positive thought. And I think it is actually difficult to be happy every day and every time. But we should try to focus on happiness, not sadness, to enhance our life satisfaction. Because we live only just once. Then I started to make a happy list. I realized my life is full of happiness. From small happiness to big happiness. So I want to encourage you to focus on happiness and enjoy your life. Also realize your lives are also full of happiness. Thank you for listening.